comparator and parity checker. At the end of this session, student will be able to design ALU comparator and parity checker. ALU provides fast arithmetic and logic functions. It handles larger words and it is a key part of many CPUs. This is one of the ALU unit 74181. So here you can see A0 to A3, this is first input, B0 to B3, this is one more input, and this is optional input, that is carry input. If we want to carry the last carry, then we can make it on. Then we are having select input S0 to S3, means 4 bit inputs are there, and it will be create 16 inputs. And then mode M, it will be having different modes. Then this is the output, and this is again supplementary outputs are there. We'll see one by one how they are creating ALU unit. Now, as we have seen that selection modes are there, S3, S2, S1, S0. So we are having this 16 inputs. Then mode, this is the mode control. So when mode is high, we are getting output logic functions. And mode is low, we are getting arithmetic function. Again, in the arithmetic, we are having with carry or without carry. So we'll see one by one. So for this selection mode, we'll select it first, A0 to A3 and B0 to B3. The inputs will be there. For that, when all S3, S2, S1, S0, all are 0, that time, whatever the A input is given, it is inverting. So this is a logic function for the inverter input A. Then next is there, it is giving A plus B bar. So this is a NOR function. Then next is there, low, low, high, low. At that time, you are getting A bar B. So these are different logic functions we are able to calculate with the help of this selection and this 74181 ALU unit. Now for arithmetic functions, as I said, it is with carry or without carry. So when Cn is high, there is no carry, and Cn is low, with carry. What is the requirement of this carry is when we are having only nibble functions, inputs are there. So when we have to add with carry, so it is automatically going for plus 1. So arithmetic functions, when all lows are there, so it is as it is, input is showing without carry, but with carry it is showing that A plus 1. Now one more we'll see, that when it is S3 is low and other is high, that time it is showing that functionality A B bar minus 1, and here it is showing with carry, so it is A B bar. So here we can calculate 2's complement also with the help of this combination, low low, high high. So it is having a minus 1, so it is a giving us 2's complement. So there are 16 combination for the selection, so that we can calculate 16 logic function, 16 without carry, and 16 with carry. So total 48 arithmetic logic functions are there. So for example, we are having here addition of A and B. A is 97 and B is 29. So these are 8 bits. But in this case, we are having only a single nibble addition. So at a time, we can add 4 bits. So here we are setting, when lower bit addition we are doing, we are putting mode is equal to 0. So it will go to the arithmetic. Then S is equal to 1001. So this is nothing but addition. In this operation, we can see that A plus B is there. Then for this lower bit, we'll put Cn bar is equal to 0. Here it is showing everything over here in this table. So this is the A. It is having mode 0 for arithmetic. 1001. It is for this addition selection. Then this is the lower nibble of A, lower nibble of B, and carry is put as 1, means it is with the no carry. So it is giving output here. So like this, we are again doing the most significant. So A, B, here we are considering carry and we are doing this total addition. So next is example is of on the same numbers we are doing the minus. So 0, 1, 1, 0, that is the selection mode we are putting that. Then A and B and without carry we are doing this operation for the minus. And this is a one more function we are showing here example, that is B. It is again doing that plus and then here minus. So there is one more function with the IC, that is the comparator. So here comparator is shown 7485. So here again we are using A0, A1, A2 and A3. So total 4 bit numbers are there, A1 and B is 4 bit numbers. So what is the function of this digital comparator? Digital comparator is comparing whatever the inputs are given. So here we can see there are three different outputs it is showing. A is greater than B, A is equal to B, or it is A is less than B. So between any two numbers it is showing the comparison, and as per that it is giving the output. If it is true, then it is giving output as 1. So here pin diagram is shown from 1 to 16. So every pin's number and its functionality is given. So if it is A is greater than B, A is equal to B, like this. And this is the truth table of this digital comparator. So here we can see one or two example here. 00 and B is at that time 00, means it is A is equal to B. So here this A is equal to B is 1. Next, if we see this example, A is 10 and B is 0, means A is greater. So here A is greater. So these are output of the digital comparator. So when our number is more than 4 bit, that time we can cascade this digital comparator. So this is the comparator 7485. Here you can see that 7485, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how your number is there or your requirement is there, you are putting the digital comparator in the cascading, and then total again you are connecting one more comparator here, and the output will be this cascading output of this all this number. Now we'll see one more circuit or functionality, that is a parity checker, that is 74180. So what is a parity checker? First we'll see that. Parity checker is nothing but it is a circuit that checks the parity. So it is called as a parity checker. So when even parity is there, means number of 1 in any number are in even numbers, then it is called as a even parity. And when any number is there and it contains odd number of 1s in that number, then it is called as a odd parity. So this parity checker 74180 will show that if your number is odd parity or even parity. So the truth table is given over here. So accordingly you are having the number, that any number here, 8 bit number is there. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, that is any number it is providing to this. And then if we are going to check if parity is even or odd, so accordingly it is giving the output of that number. And these two more pin are there for having cascading. If we want to cascade that parity checker IC, then we can cascade with the help of these numbers. So one question is there, what is the use of above circuit? Here I am showing circuit is 74180. So what is the use of this circuit. So this circuit is nothing but parity checker, as just explained about this parity checker. So whatever the number given to you with the help of this IC, it will provide you output if that number is having either even parity or odd parity.